all my beans. There we go. Oh no, wait, it's Elegance that plays now, right? Yeah, it's this is gonna play in a moment. When Remy fucking dies. Ah, Remy's death. What a death. Like, here's the thing that gets me about these visits, you know, is, like, if I go to visit someone, it's not, like, you visit Anna, you visit Dean, you visit Remy, and you go by and you just kind of slide away. It creates this strong mechanical disconnect between times you go to visit someone and times you just see someone, you know? Also, Emmer's thing is so arbitrary. Like, why isn't Remy committing suicide at his office? Wouldn't that be a more logical space to do it? Like, Emmer could not sidestep it? Like, it's so weird that he takes the freaking courtesy to go to his nice little apartment to do it. You have a room for this, Remy. I can't put... Unfortunately, I can't use the character graphic for this. Because Remy hanging is probably one of the more graphic images in this. Like, I know, sure, there's a bunch of corpses. But someone committing suicide has a certain graphicness to it as well. And the fact that he puts his bow tie here. And he still wears his collar. That's the thing that gets me is... He's not wearing the tie, okay. But he's still wearing the collar. Also, his wings are no longer insectile and are now more normal. Although they have a very small surface area in this form. Especially because there's no wrinkles indicating that they're folded up or anything. Also, these pictures are stacked doesn't make any sense. Like, why are they blank frames? Also, someone had a problem with some of the shading or something? Because I guess it's weird. Maybe they're supposed to be like the angle lines. Like, oh, these are just one flat color. Nice background, though. Like, I really like the lighting. It's a real strong framing. All of this. Shouldn't have done that. Like, just go for the strong artistic framing. Keep this dark. Keep this dark. Really focus on, like, the central pyramid structure. Although, I guess the top and bottom kind of frame them as a picture. Which would be great. Like... If you extend it a bit, it puts him like a picture, similar to how he is. Oh, the thing is, you're delivering this to him off duty. You're giving someone outside of his professional capacity something like this? Like, that doesn't seem like proper procedure to me. And this justifies Remy wearing lipstick later down the line. Today is the day we're having cake for my birthday, even though my birthday was last week. Also, because they're like, it's implied that they're heads-up displays, are they wearing them for this, or did they just download the information off of it? Again, I think the reason they stopped the whole skipping thing is this clues part doesn't do anything. It doesn't achieve any objective to do this investigation right. Because again... Yeah, like, it doesn't do anything. What the fuck? Is this one referenced anywhere else? No? What the hell? So, the whole clues thing doesn't even do anything. There's no Steam achievement related to it either. Huh. Ha ha ha. This is so weird. Also, the whole silence thing is weird, but... Yeah, I think chapter 4 is chapter 4 is the scaffolding of a chapter. There's so much going on that's just kind of slightly off cue. How do, like, do all the PDAs have the same information on them? Like, are they all, like, redundant backup systems? Or are they all different? Like, I don't know. Why does he take a day off like this, anyway? Like, did you talk him out of just taking it and taking a day off? Yeah, like, these are all the... I don't even want to do the translation for this, because it's literally just the same text over and over again. The fact that the Excelman sphere gives you 2 points, and the fact that getting the skip requires you to have 2 or more points... says some things. I can't spin this too well. This is way too much. The exact same lines. I don't want to do this, because there's not much to say. He's like, okay, I've just set it in the palm of his hand, because I'm trying to spin it. Again, though, you're delivering this to him in his, on a day off at his private quarters. How is that more responsible than Emra? Oh, cool. If you've never talked to him, Remy's still like, okay, whatever. Okay, so if you have the good ending, he's always happy to see you. That's quirky. Oh, I know what he's doing this. It's doing this so that you can't sort of slide your way into a date. That's kind of... Like, that's kind of the problem, isn't it? Like, you could just take Anna out on a coffee date with the situation as it is, or here you could just... I can't imagine that if Remy's already like, it's not a good time to visit, that he's even more pissed off that he gets this shit delivered like this. Ugh. Man, though. Like, during two of these, you effectively discover that someone's life has been thrown over. Ugh. Oh, man. My armor's already starting to act up. I guess it's because of all the good D&D session today. At least they say it was. I don't know myself. Man, I really can't get back into it. I'm sometimes feeling the spark of my old or role-playing self pop up, but for some reason it's just gone. Something killed the vibe and the mood. Heavens if I can figure out what it is, though. Oof. Remy Hang. I like how it's called Remy Hang. That's not called Remy Hang. Let's give it a fancy name. And then Remy was dead. Remy doesn't get shot. Who else doesn't get shot? I think Bryce still gets fucked up at some point. Yeah, Izumi always gets... I like how Izumi has so many hair colors, too. Such a funny little detail. Actually, Bryce doesn't get fucked up, because first of the flashback, it's Anna and Adine that get fucked up. And Lorem gets kicked. I wonder if there was, like, an argument over, like, getting Lorem shot. And then it was like, no! And I was like, okay. Angry! Probably saw a banana. That fucking collar gets me, though. Like, what the fuck is that collar about? What is this whole shirt about? Why does this tuck in the back while this tucks in the front? Questions, people! Questions! Oh my god, this is so much work. And then comes the hatchery, which isn't going to be any better. Okay, alright, and there's a little... Yeah, the music cuts out at this part. It's a gravity. I think I got this one on my first playthrough, did I? At least I wasn't hanging out with him. Yeah, if I was only hanging out with him, he doesn't die. He only dies if you specifically are a dick to him. Which makes his death kind of doofy. Again, let's run through. We need to do Adine 4, Anna 2, Lorem 3. So you can't do it, because there's only 4 chapters. Even though 2 characters don't die without your prompting. Still didn't have enough time. I don't think that was a requirement. Like, that was one of the reasons why the whole Lorem thing is so weirdly set up. How does he not have family? What's all this with people who are like 20-something and just have no family? What? Is that just a dragon thing? Like, I'm 20 years old. My family is gone. What? Man, this doesn't make Sebastian's workload any easier. Although he does get reinforcements around this time, so... you Wow, he just repeats himself here, huh? I'm not gonna bother with this. I'm just not in the mood for this. Like, no one's gonna do this twice. No one's gonna be the asshole to Remy twice. Remy also dies after this, regardless of what you do, so... Again, though, the fact that he's like, at one hand, he's like, society needs to stop this. Oh, but this corrupt person is totally fine if they get away with something just because they're in a high position. God damn it, Sebastian, you can't have your cake and eat it too. You can't be like, our society needs to help these people, and at the same time be like, other people deserve our protection more than others. Because that's really the aura you're sending out with this. Like the constant bullying thing, ugh. Yeah, that's another part, is that you really only see it a couple of times. Like, you get the impression more of it happens, but at the same time, there's a lot of... This goes both ways. You gotta set the law up that it's not abusable. It's not too easily abusable, but it also protects people that are in situations that are hard to prove, which is a very fine, fine line to walk that also conflicts with itself. Like, you can't solve it. It's an unsolvable problem because people will lie and people will cheat to achieve their mission objective. And that's a sad part of society. Like, the thing to make out of this is, Remy never follows us up. Like, similar with Bryce's alcoholism, this problem is never directly addressed. It's kind of weird how many characters have, like, problems that are never directly addressed in any major fashion that revolves around resolving them. Also, this, like, again, like, the whole, you can't say this. Like, there's a lot of people who are, like, all for that shit, but ugh. Ugh. Yeah, a lot of these. I just need a second pass for this one. The music kicks back in. Fucking Midwest institution. What? Like, what? What is the situation? What is? What was Kevin's plan of attack here? Let's talk next time about Kevin and his stupid plan of attack. God, I keep forgetting that chapter 5 is just the bad parts. Here's Kevin. I got this fucking art for him. He's better than Katsuharu got. Not much is certain. Look at that. Look at that nice fluffy belly. Apparently he's a cheesehead. It's supposed to be a circle. I can see that being circlish, or at least having the. Also, the fact that he has two bands on this one, and this one is just a solid. Oh, also the fact that it's like a straight-on shot, it's slightly off kilter. Oh man, those are hard to pull off. Ooh. Look at that background, though. Hey, that takes time and effort to get that right. Ugh. Man. Like, this gives the impression of like, I know what to say. I'm done. I'm done for today. Today's not a good day. Today is not a good day, and tomorrow's not gonna be a good day because I got all the. Oh man, I got Kevin to take care of. She's annoyed. God damn it. Hot ziggity.